Hi, I'm Ignatius Sokori, the founder of Get Opaque Electrical. Welcome to our channel. Hi, I'm Ignatius Sokori. In this training, we'll be building automatic changeover. In this automatic changeover, we'll be building automatic changeover that you can use to off your generator. You can decide to use it to off your generator automatically. You can as well add a manual button that you can be using to off your generator from inside the house. Now we'll be dealing with this diagram. When you look at this diagram, you see that this is an automatic changeover diagram. This is contactor one, contactor two, because we are dealing with two contactors, and this is pin relay. And this is where you do your connection that can off your generator, all right? And this is the wire that goes straight to your house. Okay, so let's go ahead and do the connection. But remember, this is the coil of this contactor one and this is the coil of this contactor two. And looking at the components, you see that I have arranged the contactors, contactor one and contactor two, and this is the pin relay. And this is the manual switch you can use to off your generator from inside the house. I'll be making use of this as the load to your house, and I'll be making use of this because it's a single phase automatic changeover. I'll be making use of the supply one and supply two. All right, so let's go ahead and do the connection. So looking at the diagram, you see that supply 1, which is the utility supply PSEN, connects to LU1 and LU2 of this contactor 1. So let's connect it. So I'll be using this, and this is the supply. I will connect the live wire to the LU1 of this contactor 1 and the neutral wire to LU2 of this contactor 1. So looking at the diagram again, you see that the LU1 connects to terminal number 2 of the pin relay, and the same terminal number 2 connects to terminal number 6 of the pin relay. So let's connect it. So this pin relay, I'll go ahead and I'll remove the pin relay, remaining the base. So terminal number LU1 of the contactor 1, which is here, connects to terminal number 2 of the pin relay. This is the terminal number 2 of this pin relay. Alright? And this, so the same terminal number 2, which is this, connects to terminal number 6 of this pin relay, which is this terminal number 6 of this pin relay here. Alright? So looking at the diagram again, you see that terminal number LU2 connects to terminal number A2 of the contactor. The same LU2 connects to terminal number 10 of the pin relay. So let's connect it. So this is terminal number LU2 of this contactor 1. Alright, so we connect from this terminal number LU2 of this contactor 1 to terminal number 10 of the pin relay, which is this terminal number 10 of the pin relay, right? So the diagram, you see that LU2 also connects to A2 of this contactor 1. So this is we connect from the same LU2 of this contactor 1 here to A2 of the contactor 1. Now this is the terminal number A2 of this contactor 1. Remember, A1 and A2 of this contactor is the coil terminal of the contactor. So this is the A2 of this contactor 1. Looking at the diagram again, you see that terminal number 7 of this pin relay connects to terminal number A1 of contactor 1. 6 and 7 are normally open, 2 and 10 are the input terminals of this pin relay, and the 11 and 8 are the normally closed. So terminal number 7 of this pin relay connects to terminal number A1 of the contactor 1. So let's connect it. So this is the terminal number 7 of this pin relay here. So, and it connects to terminal number A1 of the contactor 1. Now looking at it, you see that this is the terminal number A1. So this is terminal number A1 of this contactor 1, all right? So looking at the diagram again, you see that for generator supply goes to LU1 and LU2 of contactor 2, all right? So let's connect generator supply, this generator supply. So we connect it to LU1 and LU2 of contactor 2, this contactor 2. So this is LU1 of this contactor 2, all right? And this is LU2 of this contactor 2 here. So looking at the diagram again, you see that the LU1 connects to terminal number 11 of the pin relay, all right? So let's connect it. So this LU1 here connects to terminal number 10 of the pin relay, terminal number 11 of the pin relay, which is this. This is terminal number 11 of this pin relay. Alright, so looking at the diagram again, you see that terminal number 8 of the pin relay connects to terminal number A1 of the contactor 2. So this is the terminal number 8 of this pin relay here. This terminal number 8 of the pin relay here. Okay, and this connects to terminal number A1 of the contactor 2, which is this. This is the terminal number A1 of this contactor 2 here. Alright.
So now from the diagram again, you see that terminal number L2 of this contactor 2 connects to terminal number A2 of this contactor 2. So let's connect it. So terminal number L2 of this contactor 2, which is this, connects to terminal number A2 of this contactor 2, which is this. This is terminal number A2 of this contactor 2. Now looking at the diagram, you see that T1 of this contactor 1 connects to T1 of contactor 2, T2 of contactor 1 connects to T2 of contactor 2, and the load to your house comes from T1 and T2 of the both contactors, okay? So now we connect T1 of this to T1 of this. Now this is T1 of contactor 1 here. Okay, connect to T1 of contactor 2, which is here. Now T2 of contactor 1, which is this, this is T2 of contactor 1, connects to T2 of contactor 2. So this is T2 of contactor 2, and the load to your house connect to T1 and T2 of the two contactors. So I'm going to connect the load to the house because I'm using this as the load to the house, so I'm connecting it to this T1 and T2 of the contactors. So I will connect one of the wires to T1 and the other wire to T2 here. Alright? So this is the load to the house connect to T1 and T2 of the two contactors. So let's go ahead and see the diagram again. Now looking at the diagram, you see that we have finished connecting the main automatic changeover. What we are about to connect now is to off the generator using this 13 and 14 terminals of this contactor. So let's connect. So looking at it, you see that these are connectors, the two connectors, just like this. This, the two connectors, this one, two connectors. Looking at it, you see that from the connector, okay, because wire to your generator must go to the connector. But first of all, from the connector, you connect wire from the connector to terminal number 3 of this switch. This is terminal number 3 of the switch, and the same wire goes to terminal number 13 of the contactor. You connect another wire to terminal number 4 of this switch, which is this, and the same terminal terminal goes to terminal number 14 of the contactor. So let's connect this. First, we connect wire from this connector to 3 and 13 of the contactor. So let's do it. So looking at it, you see that this is a connector. So now we are using this connector. We put two wires inside this one connector, okay, and we tight it. Now one of the wires go to the terminal number 3, as explained in the diagram, okay, number 3 of this switch, and the other of the wire goes to terminal number 13 of this contactor, and this is terminal number 13 of this contactor. Alright, so we have connected it. Looking at the diagram again, you see that the second connector connects to terminal number 4 of the switch and goes to terminal number 14 of the contactor. So let's connect it. So this is the second connector. So what we do is we put two wires as usual in the second connector. One of the wires goes to terminal number 4 of the switch, which is this. Okay, so you put it and you tight it, while the other wire goes to terminal number 14 of the contactor. This is the terminal number 14 of this contactor here. All right. So looking at the diagram, you see that two wires go to your generator. These are L1 and L2 that goes to your generator. So we are using these two wires. We connect one wire to this first one connector, and the other one connect to the other connector. All right, so now these are the two wires. So these are the two wires that we will connect to the generator. So now looking at it, now we are done. So what we do is we socket back this pin relay. All right, we are done with this connection. So we first of all test the automatic changeover before we go ahead and test with generator. So in testing, you see that this is our generator supply and this is our utility supply. So when you are using your generator just like this, you see that the load is on and there won't be any supply to the utility. Then when utility supply enters the house, you see that it will take over the supply just like this. And even if you remove the generator, there's nothing like supply at the generator now because utility have taken over. Alright, so let's go ahead and test with a generator to see how it will off the generator, because we are going to off the generator automatically as well as off the generator manually with this switch. So let's go ahead and do it. So this is the generator we are going to use. Now looking at it, you see that this is the on and off of the generator, right? So we are going to open the generator. Let me show you something inside. When you open the generator like this, you see that from inside, this is the start. This is the key. That is the start and stop of the generator display. So what you do now is you join two wires in parallel to this place, okay? That is, you join one wire to this terminal and the other wire to the other terminal, okay? Okay, so you have seen how we put the wire. You see that one wire is connected to the first one, then the other wire is connected to the second one, just like this, okay? So this is how you connect the wire to the switch, one wire to one, the other one to one, that is parallel to the two of them, all right? That's the wire that we connected. If you watch, the wire come from this off connector. That's the place that we connected the wire that's kind of off the generator. Okay, so as I'm starting it, let's just go ahead and test. Okay, so let's test and see how it will off the generator.
So looking at it now, you see that the generator is on and I will socket it. You see that the supply that is coming now is from the generator, okay? And when utility supply comes in, because here, I'm using utility supply here. When utility supply comes in, it has to off the generator, just like this. Alright, so just like this, you see that the generator now is off, that the automatic changeover have off it. Okay, so let's go ahead and see how you can off using the manual changeover, okay? Because manual switch, because as you are seeing now, the NEPA, that's the utility supply, have taken over the load. So let's go ahead and off manually with this. So off on the generator again. So looking at it again, you see that the generator is on and the generator is supplying. So when you want to off it, you can put this one inside your house, immediately you press it, okay? You see that you have off the generator. So this is how you off the generator with a manual, and this is the automatic offing of the generator, all right? Okay.
All right. Thank you for watching. I still remember my humble self, Engineer James Okori. And don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel. Just click on the subscribe button and you'll be seeing all our videos. Thank you for watching. Thank you.
All right. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel for more videos.